I took a lot, yo.
Hello? I wish I was a little bit taller. I wish I was a baller. I wish I had a girl who looked good.
Are you Princess Silk?
I had a rabbit in a hat with a bat and a 6-4 baller. I wish I was like 6'9" so I could get with Leo. She, cause she don't know me, but yo, she's really fine. You know, I see her all the time, everywhere I go. And even in my dreams, I can scheme a way to make her mine. Cause I know she's living fat. Her boyfriend's tall and he plays ball. So how am I gonna compete with that? Cause when it comes to playing basketball, I'm always last to be picked. And in some cases, never picked it off. So I just lean up on the wall or sit up in the bleachers with the rest of the girls who came to watch they man ball. Dag y'all, I never understood black. While the jocks get the fly girls and me, I get the hood rats. I tell them scat, skittles, kabobble. Got hit with a bottle, was in the hospital for talking that mess. I confess it's a shame when you living in a city that's the size of a box and nobody knows your name. Glad I came to my senses, like quick, quick, got sick to my stomach. Overcome it by thoughts of me and us.
Oh, ciao, ciao, voila. Here is your sweet and sound Princess Silke. Intelligent I am, and I a little bit of culture. This is a classical of classical music. Wolfgang Amadeus Mozart, a little night song, it's called Eine kleine Nachtmusik, just so for your little box of I know stuff. Good morning, America. Here is your sweet and sound Princess Silke. Intelligent, observative. And is Mozart my favorite composer? You're joking, right? I am multifaceted. I have many tastes. And he is definitely one of them. Because of its easy access. I think Mozart is very easy access to classical music. So is Bach. And so is Vivaldi.
Maybe I'll never know your name. Still I can picture us.
This is open mic. I do wish to emphasize today in what I began to talk to you about yesterday, which is from stimulus to action. And how to achieve the path to enlightenment. And enlightenment just means to shed light over your being. It means that you are aware of what you're doing. And ultimately that you are able and capable to make choices for yourself. Before enlightenment, people usually just react. A stimulus is something which triggers you. It could be someone who talks to you in a way. So you deem to need to say something in return or do something in return. How are you doing? Fine, thank you. That was a stimulus and a reaction. Oh, I never do that. I never did. When someone asks me, how are you doing? I think about it. And then I consider what the person is really asking me. Usually they don't ask you. They just throw in a few phrases. Phrases which things make. See, I can't even speak clear because it makes no sense. It's all upside down, in reverse. So I notice, so I don't say anything, but I made the choice. Oh, I do say anything, and I made the choice. Oh yes, I remember. In Germany, they don't ask you much, but in Mexico, they ask you constantly. I also made them aware. You want to know about it? Okay. They would ask in Mexico what happened. instead of how are you doing, they say what happened? ¿Qué pasó? It's an informal way of saying how are you doing. What happened? So I would say, this morning I woke up and I come really quick and I want my breakfast and then my breakfast made blah, blah, blah. So I would talk really, really, really quick and would tell them a story. And my blender didn't work. And then I went to my car and then my tires. And you know what then? And my neighbor looked up and she said and blah, blah, blah. No, not that fast. But I would tell them and they would look at me, what the hell? What just happened? Well, you asked me what happened. I made them aware. No, of course it was a joke. I was making fun of the circumstance and situation that people would ask you. That's a very easy and simple way. But you can also just say what you usually say. You want me to expand? Okay. I know I'm too fast sometimes. I have to pay attention to this. What happened? Yeah, it's difficult to say, how are you doing? Without getting all intellectual. How are you doing? Turn that around. How am I doing? How am I doing what? Let me think. See, it's not offensive in Mexico when I say these things. It's not offensive. It's funny as shit. Because, no, I'm thinking about it. It would be too intellectual to respond in English to a phrase like that. And make an illusion of what is really asked. But in Mexico, I did not have to say, after they looked at me, what did you just say? I did not have to say, you asked me what happened. They knew it. Because they always pay attention. Yeah, intrometidos, chismosos y maleados, often. Yeah, they are like gossipy, staring at other people. Oh yeah, in Mexico, I was constantly staring. And they also ask questions, but they don't really mean it. You can also just say what you usually say. How are you doing? Fine, thank you. If you make awareness, that's what you want to say. It could be so very many different things. I don't know if you meet people like that. They can just acknowledge you. Hey, I acknowledge you. It could be a form of namaste. Namaste meaning I honor, you know, your potential divine within you. That you're just a person, I'm just a person, and be good. That could also mean how you're doing. And you can respond with your usual phrase. But with the awareness, and that is a path to enlightenment, that you are aware. There must have been